Hello, my name is Louisa, and I first met Dr. Bottger in 2014. At that time, I probably weighed close to 240 pounds. He examined my body and told me that it would be great if I could be closer to 200 and that we'd get better results before we attempted any plastic surgery. A little while later, I came back at 214. He looked at me again and said, "I'd still like you to be less than 200, but I think we can move forward." So we did a couple of photos, and even doing the photos gave me the encouragement to know that all of the years that I struggled with self-esteem and being so self-conscious and so self-critical of what others thought of my body, that additional time when Dr. Bottger encouraged me to keep working on myself and said that surgery alone wasn't the answer, changed my life. Because from that appointment, when I weighed still more than 200 pounds, I really dedicated the next few months of my life to minding my impulses, changing my eating habits, and just adopting a healthier lifestyle. All the while I was studying what things that I could do to boost collagen production and how to eat healthy so that your scars would dissolve as quick as possible. Much to my surprise, when it was time for my pre-op appointment, only about 6 months later, I weighed in at 147 pounds. Not going to say it's all because of Dr. Bottger, but it's all because Dr. Bottger encouraged me to have more self-discipline and to care about my body in a different way. And once I got my mind right, my body followed. And so even at 147 pounds, you would think, oh, I should be so happy. But the truth was, I had more self-confidence because now I knew I could do it. But my self-esteem still suffered. I had those small, ever so slight, extra skin rolls, and they just weren't beautiful to me. They were a beautiful journey, and they reminded me of the big girl I used to be, but it took me to a place that I was still self-conscious of wearing sleeveless shirts, and I still would never, ever don having my midriff show or ever even think to make love without a t-shirt on because of the way that my skin looked. So, guess what? It started in June of 2018 when I had my first surgery with Dr. Bottger, my brachioplasty. I have to admit, I was scared. And even afterwards, the first few days looking at the scars, I had wondered if I made the right choice. But it wasn't long before the scars healed and my arms for the first time were beautiful and I could wear them without sleeves, without jackets, embracing my full beauty for the first time in 44 years. And then as the summer went on, I realized that if I could do this, I could also do my abdomen. And in August of 2018, I had a full circumferential body lift, and I was scared. But at the end of the day, I trusted Dr. Bottger, and his staff made me feel so welcome, having all my appointments scheduled, giving me everything in just the right sequence so that I didn't have to worry. And the most important thing was that Dr. Bottger took his time. He could have did it quick and easy and got me in and out and left me walking out of the hospital with drains, but he didn't. He took the extra time, and his stitching is uncompared to any. Since the time of my surgery, I've done some Hollywood things and I've been on national TV in a bikini, and everyone is so amazed. They can't believe that I had no drains. I can't believe that I was up walking, teaching a class only 3 days after a full circumferential body lift. Now, while I realize my results are extraordinary, these can be your results too.
If I would have given this talk last July, I would have weighed 272 pounds. This is my shirt from last year. It's an extra large. These are my pants from last year. They're a size 18. This is the fat suit I used to wear. And in fact, the last time I was a guest on the Steve Harvey Show, little girls in the dressing room would say, "Ooh, that's just like Fat Amy." These are the sleeves I used to have to wear to be able to wear shirts because you couldn't stand to look at my arms. Then something magical happened. I started dropping the weight, and wow, I was a size 8. This shirt is a size 8, and you can verify the sizes later. Then I got really excited. I was a 6. Hallelujah. Now the new year had come, and I had graduated. I was no longer an 8, I was a 6, and I was only hoping to be a 10. So I was beyond joy with what I was capable of. Keep in mind, I have not went for one walk. This is all what I put in my mouth. I was super excited when I became a medium. And I could barely stand my clothes. And then I went from medium to small. From a size of 18 to a small, now to an extra small. And last week, I did the biggest thing that I was afraid of that gave me freedom forever from fat sleeves and long sleeves, and I had brachioplasty extended, and now, forever, I am free from fat.
Here's one thing we know. Women are strong, but we're not unbreakable. While there have been major advances in what we're supposed to do about this fat acceptance movement, there's still so much work to learn what it's like to be a woman of varying sizes, shapes, and colors. Our ability to engage in change involves collaboration. It's interesting that sometimes we forget. Have you asked yourself, who am I? I can tell you, you're more than your name, you're more than the job that you put all those hours in, you're more than the house you live in, you're more than the time you spend cleaning, you're more than the thoughts that you have of your body, you're so much more. But you have to realize that this body is where you live. You have to spend some time doing this fierce inventory of what you want to do with the gifts that you've been given. Because being overweight carries a stigma that results in demoralizing feelings of shame. And too often, onlookers judge or bully us. They think we're lazy. I can assure you, I wasn't lazy, but I was fat. It wasn't a lack of willpower either. It was just that lack of ability to me to make myself a priority. More than 93 million of U.S. adults are obese. 80% of adults and 1/3 of our children are now classified as obese. More Americans live with obesity than cancer, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, and HIV put together. And the medical community responds to this sometimes by blaming fat people for being fat. And the fat acceptance movement that was pioneered half a century ago, it's outdated. Why is it outdated? Because there's no objective standard to actually change it. All the evidence from decades of research suggests that rather than keep going with this negative approach, we need a straightforward method. And that method is knowing your number. You need to know your weight. We need to separate the people from the positions, and we need to generate new possibilities. And at whatever cost, you need to know your number, pound by pound, ounce by ounce, and own it. Sometimes you can celebrate it, but if you don't like that number, then you have to transform it. My plea to you is to be honest with yourself and others. The numbers don't lie. Brené Brown's research on vulnerability, human connection, and authenticity prove that we have to become uncomfortable in order to get comfortable. And we have to decide that being uncomfortable and living in shame and fear, it can't be the antidote. It's often the source. And the reality is, we do not have to be afraid of fat anymore. You do not have to be afraid of fat anymore. Rather than fat acceptance, end that self-betrayal and do the simple thing to know your number and to embrace a revelation of fat competence. Because only when we do this can we truly objectively improve health outcomes and contribute to the elimination of fat acceptance and fat shaming. The new reality is you have fat, but weight is just a number. It's not a person, it's not a feeling, it's not a value. The key to physical transformation is self-leadership. With inspiration, infrastructure, knowledge, and evidence, your what and your why. And your evidence
Your evidence is your weight, and that's going to assess your success as you reflect and you refine your efforts. Your weight moving in the right direction breeds confidence and self-esteem. Recently, I saw a television commercial that was pretty inspirational. It was a young boy, maybe you've seen it. He was standing high above a diving platform. He's like looking out on the water, petrified to dive in. And you can physically see his fear. But guess what? He jumps and he dives in and he swims. And in that moment, you can see that in that moment, his confidence is born. The moment that you accept responsibility for everything in your life is the moment that you can change anything in your life. The moment that you step on the scale and know your number is the moment that your physical transformation begins. I wasn't born with a beautiful body. I got the beautiful mind instead. My transformation was all up to me, to have the courage and the strength to define my own beauty and to be kind to myself and to cultivate a body where I was unashamed to be naked. Just like many others, I made mistakes along the way. And just like many others, I learned from those mistakes. Because you do not transform by making excuses or complaining. You do not transform by accepting. You transform by becoming okay with being uncomfortable. Do not try to improve your self-confidence by commiseration, because it's most important to validate others and to lift people up. We rise by lifting others. Get ready to become your best self. Get real with yourself and know your number. Change the physical things that you can no longer accept. You live in your body, and you are the greatest project that you will ever work on. You have the power of physical transformation. Thank you.